Is Edward Snowden here in the transit lounge of Moscow Airport? Well, I haven't seen him, and there have been a lot of reporters here over the last couple days. They haven't seen him either. He could be in a VIP lounge or a diplomatic lounge if he's here. But if he does come out into the main transit lounge, which is quite quiet at the moment, he could always use Burger King and get a taste of home. This is Terminal E, the focus of this espionage story. This is one of the many huge terminals here in the Moscow airport. And it's massive for all the transit passengers. I'm gonna walk it to see exactly how long it is. It's taken about 3 minutes to walk in this terminal. And one of the benefits of a 24-hour terminal is that many of the little bars and restaurants are open. That means that if Edward Snowden needed a drink or a sandwich, he could, in theory, come and get one. And that means that passengers don't have to rely on vending machines to have a drink or a candy bar overnight. And duty-free remains open as well, so anybody could get a present or a gift. Again, it's a 24-hour airport, which is helpful for people who are transiting through here. Not so helpful if you're Edward Snowden and not sure where you're going next. Well, I don't suspect he's one of these weary travelers. But for those who can afford it, there is this tiny hotel attached to the terminal. And some people thought Edward Snowden could be staying here. It's sparse accommodation indeed. But for most travelers who know their next destination, they only have to pay by the hour. Jim Bolden, CNN, inside Moscow Airport.